Why do we need project management? Why is it so important? And what is project management all about? And to start with, what are typical examples of projects? Take, for example, a bridge. It was designed and developed by multidisciplinary teams. It was built in a certain time frame. And, also important, it serves a purpose of connecting different pieces of land. Or plant. Different setting and context, but rather similar characteristics. Something unique, realized within certain constraints, facing technological challenges, and, last but not least, enabling the creation of value for a company. Or a highly innovative part of a high-tech system. Again, different context, but check the similarities with the previous examples. Certain constraints, multidisciplinary teams that join forces, high levels of uncertainty, fulfilling a need, solving a problem. Projects intend to create value. But also closer to your home situation, you can find projects. Think of building a shed in your garden or moving house. Most probably, you would set your budget and involve a team of specialists to make your dream come true and not end up in a nightmare. Even developing this MOOC took place in a project setting. We started defining our goals, we carefully prepared the design, and ended up delivering this course to you. All ingredients of a project come together in Professor Turner's complete definition of a project. In essence, a project is a temporary organization brought to life to deliver a unique scope within the given boundary conditions. Whatever the unique character of a project is, it will always have a number of distinct phases. A typical project life cycle consists of several phases. In the first phase, a potential future project is identified, the potential value is assessed, and the alignment with the business strategy is verified. In the second phase, different options are investigated and a preferred solution is selected. In the third phase, the project is defined in more detail and funding needs to be obtained. At the end of this defined phase, the investment decision can be taken. And these three phases together, appraise, select and define, are called the front-end development phase of a project. Only after a positive investment decision, the building phase can be entered. This is phase four. And then in phase five, the project is handed over to the client. Between these phases, stage gates are defined. And at these stage gates, project reviews take place and it's decided whether or not the project can enter the next phase. But to review a project, we need to know something about project success. What seems successful for one can be perceived very unsuccessful by others. Take the famous example of the Sydney Opera House. It's claimed a failure in terms of project management and at the same time a huge long-term business success. How come? To define project success, we should realize that it contains various dimensions. The traditional way of looking at success is by time, cost and quality. This is what in the literature is called the iron triangle. Basically, this is project efficiency. The customer, however, needs to be satisfied, isn't it? Without a satisfied customer, no future business. And in an even longer term, we should develop our resource base to be prepared for the future needs and challenges. So project success is not just a simple single statement. Early in the project, you need to clarify which type of success you're going for. And only then you know on which aspects you can steer your project. Let's now go back to the project life cycle. The final investment decision, we call it FID, is quite an important milestone. In the early project phase, your level of influence is high and the scope can be changed relatively easy, without too much impact on the overall cost and schedule. At this stage of the project, most of the work performed is just paper-based. In the worst case, a lot of man hours are wasted if the project does not continue. This is completely different after FID, the investment decision. Then expenses increase quickly, for example, because of the ordering of equipment with long lead times. The influence level during the execution phase therefore decreases rapidly, and changes are much more difficult to implement. So defining your project very well is essential for a smooth execution later on. Hence, a thorough front-end phase is crucial. It's not only for financial reasons that it's wise to invest in the front-end phase of a project. is also wise from a value creation perspective. A project that's well defined in front end has a good starting point for becoming successful, assuming that the later project phase of execution and operation are also managed well. An ill-defined project, however, can never be turned around into a very successful one. The potential of value realization is created in the early project phase. But of course, a well-defined project can still be derailed or even destroyed by failing management in later project phases. For us, the essence of project management is in an integrated, phased approach of project management. Integrated in a sense that the overall project lifecycle is considered, but also integrated by involving different players in an early stage of the project. It's not about silo management, it's about bringing together the parties throughout the supply chain, already in the early phases. From our research, we concluded the importance of the early project phases. Value is created not just by starting the works, but by carefully thinking up front and trying to really understand the problem at hand. Lots of challenges in project execution can be traced back to an insufficient front end. Hence, let's think before we act. And it's not only about front end activities performed following a structured approach. Yes, this is a necessary ingredient of successful project management, but it's not sufficient. In the end, it's about the people that actually perform the project. The team can make or break the project. People are key. An essential ingredient of project management is the selection of a heterogeneous team, fitted to the specific project characteristics and project context. And even before selecting the team members, the right project manager should be appointed to the job. Not the project manager that simply is available, but the one that seems best equipped to do the task. And this brings us to a more strategic part of project management. Most companies perform multiple projects at the same time, sharing resources. How to select the right project for your company? To improve the chance of project success, the alignment of project goals with the company goals is crucial. If your project goals do not align with the higher level company goals, it will be harder to get support for your project whenever needed. Hence, while you're defining your project, make sure that there is a strategic fit between your project's goals and your company's goals. Next, it's about adding the project to the overall portfolio of projects in your company. Does it fit? Do you have the right resources available to execute the different projects? When deciding upon individual projects, the business case could play a central role. The business case shows the value of the individual project. It includes both sides of the coin, investments as well as the expected benefits. And the business case should not only be approved at the final investment decision, but also checked when a project progresses from one stage to another. This video was about the need and importance of project management and the basic ingredients of project management. Or, summarized in one sentence, project management is about doing the right project in the right way.